Let's export torso, legs and feet meshes. Navigate to casual sneakers material and open it. Navigate to textures and bulk export them. Same procedure with the jeans. Here we have micro cloth textures. Let's bulk export them just in case. Finally, let's export t-shirts textures. Let's tidy up the textures. Import clothes meshes into Blender. Unparent armatures and delete remaining empties. Unparent meshes and delete remaining armatures. Let's rename the meshes. Select CrewneckT mesh and go to Shading tab. Let's delete this node. To efficiently work with shaders, Node Wrangler add-on must be enabled. Navigate to CrewneckT textures folder. Change this file name so it contains NRM. And this one so that it has COL in its name. With principled BSDF node selected, press Ctrl+Shift+T. Navigate to CrewneckT textures folder. Select both texture images and press Enter. Node Wrangler has automatically added and arranged nodes. We will not deal with these nodes, so let's minimize them. Press Shift+A and add a color ramp node in between here. We can change colors by adjusting black and white handles. Colors are somewhat dull. That's because output averages 3 color channels. Let's add a separate color node. Green channel has the most contrast color information, so it gives the brightest color. You can see that in an image editor. Finally, let's add stitches. Duplicate principled BSDF shader and mix it with the original. This masking texture for stitches. Let's put it together with other textures. Connect its color output to factor of mix shader node. Select both shaders and press Alt+S to swap outputs. Let's change color of stitches. Let's look at what we've done in maximized view. Nodes are arranged like this. Now let's work on jeans. Again, let's delete this node. List of tags for auto texture detection is located here. Let's change names of texture maps. This color map should contain COL. This normal map should contain NRM. And here let's remove NRM from roughness. Back in Blender, select the shader and press Ctrl+Shift+T. Select color, normal and roughness maps and press Enter. A lot of work is done automatically. Let me minimize these guys. Let's bring the style texture inside. Add a bump node in between here. Connect color output to height of bump node. Select this texture and press Ctrl+T to add mapping and texture coordinate nodes. Increase X and Y scale in mapping. Let's decrease metallic and IOR parameters. Let's decrease bump strength. Increase normal map strength. Let's rename the BSDF shader. Select these nodes and duplicate. Mix these shaders. Let's rename the copied shader. Remove bump and roughness texture nodes. Bring this texture with mask into the editor. Connect its color to the factor of mix shader node. Increase metalness.
Select these shaders and swap their outputs.
Connect these guys.
Decrease roughness value. We'll deal again with normal map in a moment. Here let's separate color channels and connect the blue one. Let me adjust the strength of normal map. Also the one for the cloth shader.
This is the node arrangement. And this is what jeans look like with applied textures. Okay, now let's look at casual sneakers. Just like before, let me delete this node. Navigate to casual sneakers texture folder.
Rename these images.
Select the shader and press Ctrl+Shift+T. Select color and normal map texture images, then press Enter. Let's deal with the rings for laces.
Duplicate principal BSDF shader and rename it.
Mix two shaders. Bring this masking texture inside. Connect its color to the factor of the mix shader.
Select both shaders and swap their outputs.
Let's change base color. Let's add a separate color node in between here. Most contrast channel is blue in this case. Go to UV editing tab. Change colors of sneakers parts by painting the color map texture. Activate UV sync selection. Unlink the active material. To follow along, you need to install and activate text tools add-on. In color ID, choose color palette, for example 5 Mustang. Now select region of island you want to paint, then expand selection and assign a color. Repeat this process for all parts whose color you want to change. In baking section, choose diffuse map. Activate cycles render engine. Activate use nodes for each new material. Select 5 Mustang color palette again and bake.
Save the resulting color map under a different name.
And incrementally save Blender file just in case. Go to shading tab. Unload all new materials and apply the old one. In base color texture node, choose the newly rendered image. Cool. Every color is applied exactly where it needs to be.
Now it's very easy to change colors once we've prepared the template.
See you in another tutorial.